Morning, thanks very much for joining us. I'm joined by Naomi Bromley, Deputy Secretary of the Department of Health today, who's going to talk a little bit about kids' vaccines and speak in more detail to a couple of important announcements that I'll make in just a moment. Before then, obviously a few key statistics overnight. So 861 people are in hospital. That's an increase from 818 yesterday. 117 of those are in ICU and 27 of those are on a ventilator. Both of those numbers are down one. I'm sad to have to report that 13 Victorians with COVID have passed away. And of course, we send our best wishes and our sincere condolences to their families. This will be a very difficult time for them. In terms of test results, we had some 59,670 PCR results come to us overnight. That meant there was a further 19,491 positives from PCR tests and 18,503 people who had reported their positive, registered and reported their positive rapid antigen test. Can I thank both those who are in queues and have queued up to go and get a PCR test and all the staff who are making that happen. I thank them very much, and also to those who have undertaken a rapid antigen test at home and have then, if positive, have gone and registered. That is a much better system, and it means people are getting their results as fast as possible. Now, I know there's some pressure in that testing system. It's not just in Melbourne or in Victoria, it's across our whole country. Everybody wants the same thing at the same time, and we have many, many cases in our communities right across our nation. So that means more people with symptoms, more people with a reason to test, more people going and getting tested, and that does put some pressure on our systems. I thank all the staff who are really doing their very, very best, and of course I thank all those people who are being patient, waiting for their important results. In terms of vaccination performance, and we'll have a bit more to say later this week about third doses, or what are sometimes called boosters. I think we really have to see it as a third dose rather than a booster shot. It's only when you have three doses that you've got the maximum protection, not just against severe illness, but against getting this virus and giving it to somebody else. That is, and I'll come back to that issue in just a moment in terms of what we're seeing in our hospitals. But we had, we are 93% over 12 years of age, double dosed. We have about 17.6% of Victorians 18 and over have had three doses, so we want to see those numbers continue to grow. My last update is that about half of those who are eligible for a third dose or a booster have had that third dose. We've got to do better than that in coming weeks. Now, I know it's been the holiday period, perhaps getting your third dose is the last thing on people's minds as they celebrate and spend quality time with family and friends. But now as we're getting into January, we need to focus on getting everyone who's eligible to be boosted or to get a third dose to go along, make an appointment, honour that appointment and get the additional protection, not just for yourself, but for all of us, and particularly for our health system that comes with a third dose, particularly against this Omicron variant. I know this is a lot of numbers, but I'll just run through quickly a handful more. In terms of kids' vaccinations, we've had some 39,000 bookings that are made currently since the system opened. 3,000 kids received their vaccine yesterday. And there are 43,000 spots that are currently open and available. So we'd encourage parents to get online, make one of those appointments for your kids, and then honour that appointment. We do know that this is challenging. It's yet another thing to have to do. It's another thing that we're asking you to do. But we've got a couple of announcements to make today, and I'll speak to them very briefly, and then I'll ask Naomi to go through a little bit more detail. But you would all remember that last year we recruited and worked very closely, over and above what we'd signed up to do, but we worked very closely with our community pharmacists who've done and are doing an amazing job, our GPs who similarly have and continue to do an amazing job. But it's a very different business model. They're not designed and they're not in business to run large vax hubs. So a grants program, we did this last year, we're doing it again this year, and I'm pleased today to be able to announce another $4 million of grants to GPs and community pharmacists to go into schools after hours, so a familiar environment, a well-known environment, to get our kids vaccinated. That begins very soon. Naomi can speak to the details of that. So that's just a continuation, a trusted, local, well-known environment using trusted and local, well-known, well-respected healthcare professionals, GPs and community pharmacists. They won't do that without support. It just won't happen. It wouldn't be efficient. They would lose money if they were to do that. So these grants help to take that care even more locally than would otherwise be the case. Beyond grants, we're also announcing today some 30 pop-up clinics that will pop up, as the name indicates, in schools, starting very soon. You've got a list, I think, of local government areas where those pop-ups are going to happen. We'll continue to refine and add to that list. We already have a number of state vax hubs, as you well know, right across the state. This is about additional time-limited activity in a trusted, well-known environment, taking the vaccination program to the local community that it will benefit most. And I thank Naomi and her team for the amazing job they did all through last year, making us one of the most vaccinated communities anywhere in the world. And of course, the work they're doing around third doses and the work they're doing around kids vax. We'll have more to say about third doses and the number of appointments that are available and what we want people to do later on this week. But please, if you are eligible and you've received your letter from the Commonwealth Government telling you that you're eligible, noting that that eligibility has changed, we'll be very soon down to a three-month interval. Please make an appointment. Please honour that appointment. At the moment, two doses are protecting the vast majority of people from serious illness, but it's only with three doses that you'll be prevented not just from serious illness, but from getting this virus, this Omicron variant, and therefore giving it to others. Plus, of course, we don't know what's coming at us later in the year. That's the nature of variants of concern. There have been more than one, and there'll probably be more into the future. So having the maximum protection is so important. Just finally, there is significant pressure in our health system. We know that. We absolutely appreciate that, and we again send our thanks and our best wishes to all of our staff who are doing such an amazing job. I do want to point out though that yesterday there were 3,992 hospital staff that were not available to work because they were either COVID-19 cases or close contacts of cases. There were a further 422 Ambulance Victoria staff who were unavailable to work as well. So that's at least 4,500. They are self-reporting numbers. I expect that number is in fact higher, and that does put great pressure on our system. It's not a matter of money or a matter of machines. They don't treat people anyway. It's qualified staff. It's people who provide healthcare to other people. And our staff, because we've got so many cases in the Victorian community, this is so wildly infectious, like any group within the community, there's a significant number of people who are getting this or have already got it, and the others who are isolating because they live in households with those healthcare workers. The other point to make is that 50% plus of our cases are 18 to 39-year-olds. That covers such a large part, not exclusively, but it does cover a large part of our health workforce. So it just stands to reason that that's where the pressure starts, that's where it comes from, and that's the real challenge that we face. So can I, on behalf of all Victorians, please pass on my profound thanks to two groups of people. One, everybody who is working in our health system. Thank you so much for your passion and your commitment, your skill, and the amazing work that you do. And secondly, can I thank, it's about 171,000 active cases. I think it's fair to say there's at least 200,000, maybe many more, Victorians who are isolating at home because they're a case or they're a close contact. I want to thank them for the sacrifice they're making, the contribution they're making to keeping our state safe. Now, of course, the Minister Foley yesterday announced some furloughing changes. All of those will start to take effect, and that's very important for health, for critical infrastructure, for important, critical supply chains like groceries and food. All of those issues we'll update you as we go forward, and we'll update you as well about boosters later on this week, third doses later on this week. Just finally, the last number from me, we gave out, I think, something like 34,000 rapid antigen tests yesterday at state testing sites, 56 of those testing sites. That'll be for people who are close contacts who need to test but don't necessarily need a PCR test, turning up, being given a free rapid antigen test. I'd encourage people to do that. They're available at those state testing sites. And we'll have further updates for you later, soon, as soon as we can, in relation to the orders that we placed some time ago, stocks on hand, and how we see things unfolding in relation to rapid antigen tests in coming weeks and months. That's pretty much all I had by way of update, and a couple of important announcements. Again, thanks to all those who are working in the system, but most of all, thank you to those who are getting their kids through the first dose. Thank you to all of those who've made a third dose appointment, a booster appointment, and honoured it. And please, can you just take the time, if you're eligible, if you've got that letter, please go and make an appointment, whether it's at a state clinic, a community pharmacy, or your local GP surgery, to get your third dose. That's how we will limit the spread of this. Just finally, we have some people in, obviously, that are gravely ill, some people that are in intensive care, but the vast majority of people are in hospital and not requiring that sort of care. If we were to stop isolating people, if we were to stop testing, if we were to let this rip, as some would have us do, then we would finish up not with hundreds of people on general wards, we would finish up with thousands, and we all know what that means. It means every non-COVID case that requires hospitalisation will not be able to get that care. So I know it's deeply inconvenient, I know it's frustrating to be double dose vaccinated, even triple dose vaccinated, and having to isolate at home because you've got this. I thank you very much for the contribution you're making. You're playing such a big part in keeping us safe and making sure that our health system, whilst under enormous pressure, can still cope to provide those who need the most urgent care with the care they need as fast as possible.